This is a story of Porinju, Mariam and Jose. Obviously, we've heard it around in the Y as well. So they're three wonderful characters who've grown up together. So they could be friends, there could be a little bit of love inside. So those are the things we'll have to wait and watch.
Fantastic.
So the movie, like I told you a little earlier, it is set in the 80s. So that is where they've actually grown up as adults. They've all got their problems, and why Mariam wears that particular attire,
yes,
which even in 80s, women don't usually wear that. That was back in 60s, women used to wear that attire. But why she's wearing that, there's a reason behind that.
Right.
So that's part of her character. She's a very bold person.
Yes.
She lives alone. She kind of is a don who dons the market. She is a money lender and all of that. So she's a lady.
She's a hustler.
Yeah, she is. So that is why that the attire, which gives everybody a facade that she's a very bold woman. But inside, she's very emotional. She's very light. And there are moments where she tears up. So I think this is the movie where I've cried the most.
Really?
I have literally cried in ways I have not even done in my real life. So that is what Mariam is about. It's one of the most beautiful characters. Even if it was not me, I would have really loved watching that character on screen.
Nice.
So a director like Joshi, sir, when he approached me for the character, my biggest concern was if I could actually portray that character on screen. He's coming back after 4 years, you know, so 4 years of gap. So he's coming up with a big movie, the entire
when was
industry.
What was his last movie?
His movie was Laila O Laila with Mohanlal and Amla Paul and all
it.
Of that. So he took a break of 4 years.
Fantastic.
And
so
when
4 years sabbatical, and now he's back.
And what do you say, when this movie came up to me with Joju is apparently a friend of mine, so we've been knowing each other, so he's the one who actually suggested my name to Joshi. So
it's
why did
very
you
very unlikely choice, may I add. When I saw you in this attire, I'm like, is that Nyla? I'm like, the one I see with Robinson's you know, I follow you. I stalk you on Instagram between us. I'm like, how does she shop much? Then I knew you were the ambassador, therefore some things
yes,
made sense.
Yes.
Isn't she an artist?
But
how
I do shop as well.
But I love it. I love all the shopping sprees you go to.
Correct.
And then I see you in this avatar.
Yes.
Very not glossy.
Well, it was so nice to actually be in that attire, to wear that Christian outfit.
Chata-munda.
I would never have worn that in my real life otherwise. So to get into that attire, because the way that the dhoti drapes itself is very different.
Uh-huh.
And this is my outfit throughout the movie. Though it has
it was the easiest, no costume changes, is it?
No, there are costume changes. There are different kinds of whites and blues. But it might all look the same to you, but they're different costumes.
Yeah.
But it was wonderful. Even the hairdo, I had to curl my hair up to, you know,
look the part.
Also to make myself look a little different, you know, having the straight hair and all of that.
You
looks
look
typical
very polished
Nyla
right now. So it's a very good transformation.
It
so
is,
I'm sure.
No? Yeah.
How many hours did you like?
To do that hair, it took me a lot of time. And with the humidity in Kerala, I step out and it becomes almost straight. So
I know. I can imagine.
So it was you know, we shot in this place called Kodungallur in Thrissur.
I know,
so it was
Kodungallur.
Entered.
My best friend is from there.
Is
Chavakkad, Kodungallur.
Ah, yes.
Belly.
And we shot it during the peak summer. It was really
not
tough,
nice.
And we shot in the market and all of that. And the movie is set in 80s, so there are a lot of things we can't shoot because this is all modern Kerala now. So we can't show that. So we had to wait till everybody closes the shop to do the fight scenes and chase scenes and stuff like that.
Brilliant.
So I had all that, you know, I had fight scenes and chase scenes and all in the movie.
Right.
So there were mass dialogues where, you know, I take out the Jackie lever from the car and I give a dialogue. And I'm like, are people even going to take this from an actor like me? Because, okay, for Manju Warrior or someone of that big charisma,
she did that with Kanmadam.
Yeah, she could do that. I mean, people would take it. But then if I do it, well, people will take it. But then it's all on Joshi, sir. In a Joshi, sir movie, you can expect the actress to do that.
Right.
Nothing is me in the movie. It is very unlikely, except for the fact that we all have a bold face. Whenever we want to, we just put that face and we make it. Nobody, if we're not, we don't want to talk to you, we put that face and you're not going to talk to us or mess with us. So that part of it is there. But other than that, she's not me. You know, she's a very different woman. Her attire, you know, the way she sits and, you know.
It's more like a don, female don.
Yeah.
Like a mafia.
Yeah, but then it's a very village story. So, you know, I lend money. If I like someone, I don't take interest. I'm like, okay, you don't give me interest. It's fine, you can take it. So there are light moments with children. There are a few conversations and few scenes where Joshi sir had made people understand that she's not a bad person, you know. She's got a lighter side to herself. She's a nice,
she's rough
person.
On the outside,
yeah,
but inside she's quite
a softie. That's just a facade. He's made,
you're a coconut.
Yes. Or jackfruit.
Jackfruit. But you need to tell me, what was Joshi sir's brief to you? Did he ask you to let go? Or, and he said you, no. He was very kind in the way
he did. Exactly. So the very first scene was where I was, just the script writer described, so where I'm walking down the stairs and I'm giving money to someone who comes and asks me for money for his wedding, to hold his wedding ceremony. So I go and give it to him and I say, okay, you enjoy, you don't have to give me, you know, any interest for this, go enjoy your wedding. And then they take the bike and go off, they invite me and go. So there's a backstory to why I'm saying I don't need money. So all this he told me, he came and told me, so this is why she is like this, you know. So her eyes should be a little, she should tear up a little bit because she's connecting that to her own marriage and stuff. So I did that to my, that was my very first scene. So like you said, you know, I was all scared and nervous. And Joshi sir, I've actually known him to be one of the most short-tempered directors. So I was expecting to be yelled upon. So I was like, okay, this is okay. So after that scene, he came up to me and said, you did it beautifully. So he didn't have to say that. I mean, he's somebody who's actually said, start action camera to almost
the
biggest of actors, yeah,
of Patra Manju Warrior
and yeah, so many actors. So he doesn't have to come and tell that to me. So when he came up to me and said that you've done it beautifully, when I know that I could have done much better, it was not too okay. When he came and said that, I understood that he wants, you know, this is Mariam is yours. So try and do whatever you can do out of it, and let's work together. And there are certain scenes he said, okay, when you say this, no, say it in that way, say it with a punch, it'll be good. Come on, let's see if Nyla can do that. So I do that, and I just quickly look at him. He'll be like, yeah, it's okay. So there are directors who would sit there and yell on the mic and say that it went wrong, it was not right, Nyla, come on, do this. So that actually, you know,
puts you to a... That's a bit of a bully, but yeah, that's okay.
Correct, yeah. But he's, in spite of being a director, a master director, he does this. You know, he walks all the way up to you to tell you that this was not right. Maybe
that's kind of shows respect for the actors and talent, right? You kind of like it because he's treating you well.
Right.
There's also a lot of conversation about how women are portrayed in cinema, not just Malayalam movies. And Malayalam movies generally sometimes... Is this role going to change anything? Do you think any movie has?
See, Mariam is the middle name of Porinju Mariyam Jose. So that shows protection by two characters. When you see the movie, you would understand who Porinju is to Mariam and who Jose is to Mariam. So he has actually rightly placed Mariam in the center. So there is a lot of respect the characters around Mariam gives her. There's a lot of love, and the way he has actually portrayed the character is as good as a hero. So you could say that Mariam is also a hero in the movie. So actually, when you look at it that way, as to not giving women importance in cinema, well, this character is a dawn that he has actually made.
Fantastic.
And even inside the cinema, I think he's only treated me with respect.
I know you're an outsider. You have everything to prove, I think, with every movie. So for you, what's the biggest fear when such a movie comes out?
I know, but now especially that the trailer is out and everybody is raving about it. So when people talk a lot about it, you're like, oh God, I just hope people don't come.
Yeah, with Jojo, the flavor of the season, I think. After Joseph, he's like,
he's
suddenly
on a
catapulted.
Binge, yeah.
Everybody's like, haven't you seen Joseph? I'm like, yes,
you
did.
You did, yeah.
Of course I did. I mean, such
he's
a movie.
He's a, you know... The difference between Joju and Chemban is Joju keeps asking everybody. He even asked me. He said, okay, if I do this, and I was like, come on, you're asking me. I myself, I'm praying and standing there to do that shot. But Joju asks everyone. Yeah. He asks everybody, is it okay if I do this? But Jose, I mean, Chemban is an actor who comes all prepared. He's very chilled. And when you sit in front of an actor like Chemban, you'd be like, oh my God, how could somebody be so chilled? And yeah, also, and you know, the way he does, there's a scene where he rolls on the floor and laughs and all that. I mean, like, I could have never done that, seriously.
Can you describe this character in three words?
She's strong. She is... Bold is a word which everybody uses.
Feisty? Yeah. But I shouldn't put words in your mouth.
She's feisty and she's love.